Of going to Walt Disney World for adults and seniors and retirees is not just to have a relaxing, memorable vacation, but also to have good food, great food. Because you know, eating at Walt Disney World is not just about having these Dole Whips, it's so much more. And there are so many fantastic restaurants in the parks, at the resorts, at Disney Springs. So we've decided to share with you some of our favorite restaurants in and around Disney World. Hi, it's Dan from Nancy and Dan Travel. And it occurred to us that we've been doing this for a while now, and we've never shared with you which restaurants are our favorites and why. We're going to have for you six different restaurants in and around Disney World. Start off with two in Disney Springs, and then two at Disney Resorts at Walt Disney World. And then finally, two at selected Disney theme parks. You ready? Join Nancy and I and this guy. All right, so let's start with Summer House on the Lake. This is a relatively new restaurant at Disney Springs. Nancy and I were there just this past January, and we were totally impressed. Visually, it's very attractive and relaxing. And as far as the food, it was outstanding. We started off with truffle fries and dip, as you can see here. And look at all that cheese, grated cheese on top of the fries. It was delicious. And then, as you can see us here, Nancy had the tacos, whereas I decided, and I don't typically do this, but it just sounded so good. I had the chicken tenders. And you know what? They were excellent. They were a little bit skimpy on the coleslaw. You can see that small little amount there. They also have, as many, many restaurants do in and around the theme parks and Disney Springs and so on. They have their own little area there. You can buy t-shirts and hats. And what they also want to become known for are their cookies. So we had, well, we tried four of them. Okay, if you know what I mean. But all in all, the Summer House at Lake, we'd go back again in an instant and recommend it to you. Next. Long-time favorite, not just ours, but many, many Walt Disney World adults and families, is Raglan Road. Sláinte. It's cheers from Gaelic. Now, this one, why do we like it? Well, the entertainment is fantastic. The atmosphere inside the restaurant is more of a pub atmosphere. It's terrific. Again, they also have their own particular store where you can buy all kinds of souvenirs. Here's some menus for you. Again, so you can take a look at them if you're really curious, then I would pause the video here. Now, while we're there, yes, we did happen to have some of the golden ale that Nancy and I became partial to on our visit to Ireland last August. As far as the meals, outstanding. You can see what we had here, and I'm going to focus on the sandwich on the right. It was by far the best sandwich I have ever had. It was truly outstanding. Now, they do have a braised beef entree on their menu, but for the same beef, I had the worth the weight beef sandwich. $12 less, same amount of beef, and it was truly outstanding. It was really, really good. Summer House on the Lake and Raglan Road are at, of course, Disney Springs. Next, the first of our two restaurants that we frequent a lot and really enjoy at Walt Disney World, but at the resorts. This first one is longtime favorite, Olivia's Cafe. Olivia's Cafe is at Disney's Old Key West Resort, the first Disney Vacation Club resort at Walt Disney World or anywhere in the world for that matter. We did a whole separate video, and I'll put a link towards the end so you can find it easily, on not only on Olivia's Cafe, but also several videos of Old Key West. I think you would enjoy and you might find useful if you're ever thinking of where should I stay next at Walt Disney World. Now, in addition to the ambiance, the food was delicious. And again, you can see some of the menu items there. So they open, as they call it, for brunch and for dinner. So here, it was one of the best omelets I've ever had. And what made it very unique and delicious, omelet with sour cream before. And that's the drizzle you see on top of the omelet there. It was outstanding. As far as the dinner, regardless of which entree you order, they bring out coconut-infused bread. It was delicious. You can see it here. It was straight out of the oven, and the butter just melting so quickly. It was phenomenal. The coconut-infused dinner rolls. Then I had what was highly recommended. One of their specialties is fried chicken and gravy. Again, excellent, excellent, excellent. And then to top it off, and yes, as we know, Dan does like his desserts, was their version of a key lime pie tart. Delicious. The second restaurant at a Disney resort at Walt Disney World is really not a restaurant, but we had just had to include it, and you'll see why. It's the Territory Lounge at Disney's Wilderness Lodge, Copper Creek, Boulder Ridge Villas. Now, why we included this one, there are several excellent restaurants at the Wilderness Lodge Resort, was because of something that was very, very unique. Now, as we proceed here, you can see the theming of, if you're not familiar with, the Wilderness Lodge main building and lobby. You can see some of it here. You also see the decor inside the Territory Lounge. Now, why we included it was because of this. It was the most unique and the most filling charcuterie board Nancy and I have ever had. It was phenomenal. Now, what's included? And it was incredibly reasonable. It was under $25, not including the wine, sure, but it was so filling, huge portions, and let's have someone who really knows describe it for us.
All right. Okay, so we have the capicola, raisolas and cured beef, salami, and then prosciutto. Burrata cheese has a black truffle salt, cheddar, smoked gouda, and smoked blue. You got some sesame crackers. You got pickled cauliflower, regular carrots, grapes, pickles, honeycomb. And honeycomb goes really good on that sesame cracker with those cheeses, especially the smoked blue. So enjoy.
Thank you. And you know what? If you
Thank
are
you.
Enjoying this video, that it's helping you in any way decide where to eat the next time you're at Walt Disney World, then please give it a thumbs up. That'd be great. And if you've not done so, please do subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to be notified of our next adult traveling video. We publish 1 or 2 times a week. Thank you. So this first of two restaurants in the Disney theme parks, again, is not truly a restaurant, but another lounge. So the baseline tap house. It's not really a restaurant. It's more of a lounge and a bar, but I'm telling you, outstanding food. Now, again, where exactly is it? It is just next to and just outside Sci-Fi Drive-In at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Now, the decor inside, you can see here, it's quite attractive. But what really sold it for us was not just unique beverages, but this, their charcuterie board. Excellent, very tasty, very fresh, quite enjoyable. And then our sixth and final restaurant, one of our favorites in Walt Disney World, and our second at one of the theme parks. Well, we go over to Epcot and so many restaurants there, obviously. One of our favorites, longtime crowd favorite, the Rose and Crown, modeled after an English style pub. That is located right beside or just outside the International Showcase entrance. If you're coming into Epcot from Disney's Boardwalk Resort, Disney's Beach Club, Disney's Yacht Club Resort, or the Swan and Dolphin and Swan Reserve. Now, why do we like Rose and Crown? Two things, actually. Again, you can see their menu. And again, pause this video if you want to read more about the details. Or again, you can go online. Menus are all online. First, it's where we can get some, again, delicious adult beverages. For us, usually, it's going to be Strongbow, apple cider, and then their food. They are known for delicious and huge portions of, yes, fish and chips. Nancy's more partial to their bangers and mash. Again, excellent. Well, those are six of our favorite Walt Disney World restaurants. And hopefully next time you're planning to go to Walt Disney World, this will help you decide which one of these you want to try or go back to if you've been to these before. Nancy and I hope you enjoyed this video. Here are two more videos of our travel adventures to watch. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And lastly, my email is in the description below. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.